Hey guys, welcome back to Five Live. Now, this is the power of this show. It's word of mouth. We had one guest talk about artists they work with, and now you are here today. Justin LaRose is here to talk about turning skateboards, upcycling them into things that we need.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Thank you so much for having me here.
So first, tell us what these products are and how you came up with the idea.
Well, essentially, everything I make is made out of broken skateboards. So, you know, I drive around and I take broken skateboards, which can be laminated for the wood that it is, and I go around and I get the broken skateboards from the different skate shops, and then I put them together so they can be made into new useful objects.
So now, your inventory...
Broken skateboards, does that mean you're out like in the at Venice at the skate bowl, like kind of watching for people to try and break it and stake it? Or do you go around to like kind of actual shops and they know that you're the guy to get the skateboard?
So what I've done is I drive around to the skate shops,
okay,
and opposed to like being like, you know, waiting for the dudes to break it, but I go to the skate shops and when people go to get new skateboards, they take their old skateboards and pretty much just leave them there for the trash or whatever when they go off with their new skateboards. And so with that, you know, I've made agreements with a couple of local shops, and what I do is drive around and just collect all the broken boards.
So, like this guy here.
Yep.
So do they break them, or they, I need a new skateboard because I broke it?
Yeah, I need a new skateboard because I broke it. This happens to people. If you're really good, this can happen a couple of times a month or even within minutes of having it.
Wait, if you're good, this happens?
Yeah.
If you're good at
skateboarding? This is what happens when you're good with it.
That doesn't look like good. That looks like bad.
This is a great skateboarder right here.
So wait, how does somebody, first of all, are you a skater yourself?
I am,
And
yeah.
Then did you, like, is this something that you happened? Were you a good skateboarder with all of your broken skateboards?
I wasn't, you know, the greatest, but I have a good time, you know?
Yeah.
And I definitely break skateboards when I ride them sometimes.
Well, how does a kid from Massachusetts get over here and start making art out of skateboards?
Essentially, you know, just, you know, through working with coffee and stuff like that, I was able to fund moving cross country and have a dedicated line of work. And then with that, you know, I went from a barista to a coffee roaster or a roasting assistant. And there, it came up to me that like I could take my skateboards that I love with the woodworking that I love and smash them together to make handles for the industry I love.
Which is these, and this is how we found you through Alana's Coffee, where they use your handles. But how did you figure out the actual concept of compressing these boards, making the carvings? Where did that come from?
Oh, it just comes from woodworking. You know, it's like laminations for the most part. So, you know, this is almost anything that you would do with normal pieces of wood if you needed to make a bigger piece. But this way, you know, you got to strip down the skateboards and laminate them all together, yeah, so you can make the block for the widget that you need to make.
And how many skateboards would this be?
That one right there is 4 skateboard decks.
Wow. So you put these together, but you do something that not, some people just do art where I've seen, you know, the skateboard art, but you're actually kind of upcycling, like I said, to things that are useful for people.
Oh, completely. So I've always been an industry type of person, whether it was cooking or coffee. So I make items for the coffee industry, like tampers or the Chemex collars or different handles, or I make knife handles or cutting boards, or I've even made things big enough as like a 10.5-foot conference table.
Wow.
Yeah.
I think we have the tape video of the table.
I was going to say, this is...
So it's huge.
This is the conference table. And how many, rough estimate?
Rough estimate, they took right under 500 skateboard decks to make.
Did you go to stores to find 500, or they brought them to you?
Well, I was lucky enough. I drove around and found...
For weeks?
Yeah. Well, I thank God for Long Beach. You know, there's a lot of people that reach out to me, and what they'll end up doing is they'll bring me some boards, and on top of things, you know, I'll go to the skate shops and get the different boards as well. But shoot, like, even just in a couple weeks, I can get, you know, 20, 30 skateboards.
Yeah, do skaters come and bring them to you? Like, hey, you're the guy. Look, I broke it. I'm going to go get a new one.
Absolutely.
And have you made stuff out of their boards that they've brought you?
For them, yep.
Wow. See, that's cool. So your broken boards can be turned into something like the cutting board you use for your kale.
Absolutely.
Personally. What is the first thing that you ever put together with a skateboard?
The first thing I made out of skateboards was a pendant for my wife. I made this really cool little pendant, and she was just like, she had noticed that I had kind of gotten kind of depressed, and she was just like, oh, just go make something. And I was like, you know, eh. But then when it came that I could make something out of skateboards, I lit up, and it was just epic potential to do whatever. And so with that first pendant, it was just like, I just knew it was on.
Yeah. Well, Well, kind of touch on that, you know, being in a hard place in your life and having a hard time and having a hobby mm-hmm. or something, but you had to get out there and do it. What was the push to, okay, maybe I'll try it? Because, you know, there's so many times you talk about something, don't actually do it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's a total real fear. And, like, I almost thought that woodworking was going to take away from my skateboarding because I loved skateboarding so much. But I wasn't even getting what I was looking for out of skateboarding at that point. And so when I was able to make something out of the skateboards, even the block that I made, like what you have in your hand,
yeah.
I was just like, I walked around with that for like 2 weeks and I was just like, this is the best, you know? I couldn't believe it because, and then someone was like, well, what are you gonna make with that? And I'm like, what do you mean make something with this? Like I was, you know?
Yeah.
And so my mind was blown because the, you know, the limits are, or potential is limitless for the most part.
Yeah, has anyone ever asked you to make something and that you're like, I don't know if I can do that? Or is the strangest thing you've ever made out of a skateboard?
The strangest thing I've ever made was probably that 10.5 foot conference table.
Where did that go?
Well, it's
yeah,
in...
Whose table is that? And like, what type of meetings are they having?
Yeah.
Are
Shoot.
They having serious meetings about real things? Do they know that it's just a bunch of skateboards put together? Is this in a conference room of a Fortune 500 company?
It's actually in a house in Costa Mesa that, as I understand it, is a multi-family living, like just, you know, mansion type of thing.
Yeah.
And all the walls open up and everything. And everything in this place is kind of like driftwood colored, found furniture, found wood. And then this table, which is the ultimate found furniture, is in like a gem in the center of it that just
wow.
blows up.
All right, well, that sounds better then.
Yeah, it's a family yeah. table.
It's a family table as opposed to like a CEO demanding memos.
I can only imagine.
On your skateboard
so,
table.
So you make a whole bunch of different things, but talk to us about the process. So depending on what you're going to make, how many boards you need, and then going from there to actually make it into this knife cover or the chopping block.
So I'll go ahead and, you know, somebody will contact me through the internet or whatever about anything that they're looking for. And so at that point, you know, I take measurements off a size mm-hmm. and figure it all out of what's needed, make the rough stock and just whittle it down. So like this knife handle starts out a lot bigger type of thing and just, you know, work it down to what's needed type of thing.
So you're stacking these and then you put them on. I think we have, there we go. There's a video of you.
Oh, awesome. Yeah.
Of you working. And how do you get the, then you what, you put a gloss on them? Or
yeah.
It depends on what it is?
Well, yeah. So, I mean, I'll laminate the blocks of wood to whatever the size needs to be. And then whatever needs to happen, whether it goes on the lathe and gets turned to a certain diameter, or it has to go through the process of like, you know, the woodworking of going through the table saw and routers mm-hmm. and all that in order to get to the size. And then, yeah, completely just make it all glossy and nice and shiny with all the crazy colors that go on it.
And people have been wanting to collaborate with you. One of the coolest ones you had was an MLB and Element skateboard collaboration. You made these bats for the baseball league.
Oh yeah, I was super excited.
That is, do we have a, yeah, there they are. Did you know how to whittle a bat before?
Nope, completely had no idea. I was so excited, and when it came to me that I could make one of these, it was just, it had to happen as quick as possible. So, I mean, in that first sketch, you saw me cutting down the full blanks, and then right there, turning it to the size type of thing. And yeah, it just absolutely, you know, it's, I had no idea how to do it, but you know, I went and got a Louisville slugger and took the measurements.
Just eyeballed it?
Yep, and just sat there with calipers and made it happen.
Wow, that's incredible.
Thank you.
Scott?
Yes?
Do you have any questions?
I have so many questions. So you said you're from Massachusetts.
Yep.
And I'm from New England. So
awesome.
We both know that there's not a ton of time to go skateboard when it's snowing and raining and all that. So where did the passion and how did you kind of come across skateboard? I don't want to guess your age, but I'm assuming there wasn't the X Games on TV when you were a kid. So where did it come from?
Oh no, I got in on skateboarding in Massachusetts when it first started. Well, not when it first started, but when it was growing. Yeah. And so I started in 1988 when I was 9 years old. I'm 39 years old now. And so through all the snow and everything, I would shovel off spots and so I could skate, or and I would do whatever I could do in order to go skateboard, you know? And, you know, I learned how to snowboard too and everything, but skateboarding was definitely where it was at for me. And so after everything that was needed to happen, I just, you know, I had that passion and my passion was stronger than the seasons there. So I definitely had to come out, you know, west to California in order to enjoy it year round.
Okay, so then the follow-up question there is, you come out to California and you see the palm trees and you see kind of all of the open skate territory, especially depending on when you came out. What feeling, like, tell people what that's like, for, because a lot of people who watch our show, they're from California, they've been raised here, they don't understand what it means to kind of walk out to the oasis of, like, oh, look, everything I've ever dreamed of is now in front of me. How did that feel?
Oh, it's huge. Like, that's, it's honestly like being dropped in the middle of, like, a skateboard ocean and not knowing which way to go. Like, it's one of the raddest feelings, because everywhere you go, you're skating. Like, in Massachusetts, you know, you would have, you know, people not very open to it, and it's like a hobby. But when I moved out west, it's got history and it's got so much life, and like there's skaters passing other skaters on the street, and like some of the older skaters will sit there and tell you what it was like on the hill bombs when it was just starting, and like, you know, how like outlawish it was, and like how crazy just it all started out versus like it is now. It's like it's got so much history out here.
So then, is there someone that kind of inspired you as far as in the culture, or as someone who, when you're skating and you've thought, you know, it'd be great if I could make some art for, I mean, in my mind, obviously, I grew up playing the Tony Hawk video game, so like that sort of thing. Is there someone with whom you've thought, like, oh, I could make now a really cool custom piece for kind of one of my idols? Has that popped into your mind?
Oh, for sure. And thankfully, I've gotten to work with a bunch of different pro skaters that, you know, give me material to use or work with me toward getting the finished products. But if I could ever get anything to Tony Hawk, oh my God, that would be ridiculous. Like, that guy.
Right now, Tony.
Yeah. It's the reason why I started skateboarding in 1988, you know?
Yeah.
And so, Robert, do you have a question?
Yeah, so Justin, you told me before we started the show that you do this all by yourself.
Yep.
You have, like, no employees. You're making all these things on your own.
I am, yeah.
And so it must be time-consuming to, like, to even create, like, that little handle for the beaker.
Oh, everything. Oh, yeah. The handle for the beaker is probably the most time-consuming.
Really?
Yeah, like, this guy takes a lot of work and effort. I mean, it almost looks like it's just bent around the glass, but essentially, it's, you know, you got to whittle down that outer shape, and it's actually...
Is it, like, a whole block like this,
yeah,
then?
Yeah, it's out of this. This is this.
And the designs on there are just whatever's going to come out. Do you stack by color, or you're like, this is a natural thing of whatever comes out of it?
I actually align those by color. So, I mean, you can go reach in and get, you know, 9 tails or noses of whatever sizes and shape. But I actually, like, go by color and try to get, like, the most contrast that I can in order to deliver kind of the most impact of whatever the piece is going to be.
So when you are kind of putting that all together, have you gotten it down to a science where you kind of, at this point, do you definitely know, or are you still kind of experimenting each time?
Oh, every single one is a mystery. I have no idea what any of these are going to look like until the lathe stops or until the finished piece is there, because, I mean, as you go down, different colors expose themselves and different shapes expose themselves. But I've gotten to the point where I can figure out what's going to happen with them, but I just work with them to see how it's going to evolve through the process.
All right, so Natalie, I've got two final questions.
I have one too.
Okay, so I'll two, one, two?
Yeah, one, and then yours.
Done.
Okay.
Oh, or just then one, yours, then done?
One, mine, and then your second one, or you have a follow-up?
Okay, I'll save my best one. I'll save my best one for the last part.
Okay,
okay, so you've come to our studio, you've taken a look around. Do people now kind of see and commission your work? And if so, has anything spoke to you in our room that you said, I could make something that would fit in here?
Oh, I see tons of things that I can make in here, like from the light boxes to the spoons in the background to the plant holders. I walk around and literally every single thing that's made out of wood or could be made out of wood, like it flashes across my mind what it looks like with all these crazy colors.
Wow. Which brings me to my question.
Oh, good.
I just moved into a new apartment, Justin.
Awesome.
And I'm in the business of a coffee table.
Ooh.
Is that something in your realm?
Absolutely.
Okay. And for people out there, if I want to commission you, how much is it going to run my wallet?
Well, it ends up being a little bit more expensive because you do have to make the wood before you make the project.
So what if I brought you the skateboards?
Oh, well, that helps a lot too. That definitely helps a lot. And it ends up being like all the process that goes along with like the degripping the boards and everything that has to go into the lamination.
Yeah, 'cause you do it all by
yourself? Yeah. So it's super time consuming, but it comes out with such beautiful product that it's completely worth it.
Right. You'll catch me around Venice trying to trips of skateboarders.
Picking it up.
Scott?
All right, final question. You've mentioned when you got started, you were kind of in a bummed out place, and your wife encouraged you to do it, and you made her a little pendant, and it opened up this whole world. How often do you say to your wife, thank you for the inspiration to make all of this art now?
Oh, constantly. Constantly. She is huge. She's been the reason why I've gotten everything as nice and clean, because she's got this rad eye. So she's like, you can get it better. You can get it better. And so every time I look at any of these things or anything or the evolution of everything, I thank her. I completely will stop in my tracks and thank her.
That was all I had. I figured that was in there. Yeah.
That is in there. Also, let people know where they can find you if they do need a coffee table or a cutting board or anything their heart can imagine.
Awesome. I'm on Instagram under Epically Adjustin, and you can feel free to slide into the DMs and message me anytime.
We have your Instagram up on my surface right now if you want to take that. And I asked him about the name, Epically Adjustin, like adjustment?
Yep, like constantly changing.
Constantly changing. So you can slide into DMs if you want to get some woodwork by him. Otherwise, Alana's Coffee, you'll see all of his work there as well. That's how we found you, so we have to thank them as well. Justin, thanks so much.
Thank you so much for
having me. Appreciate it.